Hi cake designers, welcome to Bake Cake Design's Dragon Cake Tutorial. This is one of my award-winning cakes in Cake International. This design can be even used for a dinosaur cake. Please do check the join button on the page. This is the structure which I made. I applied rice krispies and marshmallow mix to the base of the top board. I had only pink marshmallows and that's why the pink color. Use buttercream or ganache to hold the cake layers in place. Start layering it. I started carving after each layer to save cake and to use the crumbs later to finish the shape. This will be the rock area of the cake. The rocks are also carved from the cake itself. This is an easy method to make a carved rock cake design. Carve only little by little at a time because we can always carve more but we can't undo it. So better to be on the safe side. Carve sides. This will be the neck area of the dragon. Please don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. Let's finish the top part of the neck area. I used cake crumbs mixed with ganache to shape the smaller areas. This is an easy method to give finer details while carving. Apply the crumb coat and cool it for 20 minutes at least. This will help the cake to stay moist. Let's carve the rock part of the cake in a more detailed manner. Save all the cake crumbs for using them later. I didn't use any templates for either the dragon or for the rocks, but you can definitely use it if you want. Crumb coat the carved rock areas too. Please don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. Used the cake crumbs mixed with ganache to complete the rock shape. Ganache it too, which will give a smooth finish when we cover it with modeling chocolate. I made the structure for the horns. I twisted flower wires over the ball and then foiled them to make it food safe. Apply ganache and layer the cakes over it. Carve wherever necessary. Crumb coat it again. Use the cake crumbs to give the facial features. This is the nose area and cool it for 20 minutes. Cover with the first layer of modeling chocolate. Feel free to use any color as we will be covering it again with one more layer and smooth it according to the rock pattern. Cover the face and neck area also with any color of modeling chocolate. Shape it according to the carved features. Cover it with a final layer of modeling chocolate. This will help us to work longer with the skin textures, etc., as fondant will dry out by this time. Please don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. Draw the skin texture or patterns. I used only drawstring tool and nothing else. Did it with the freehand method. Give a crisscross pattern all over it. Each square made is then rounded at two corners to finish the texture. Gave the first layer of modeling chocolate over the horn area and allowed it to dry a bit. For the skin lines, to make them look deeper, I painted black lines all over the dragon. Also gave a pattern for the back side. Cover the inside of the neck area with a snake-like shape and pattern for a unique look. Cover the horns with a second layer of modeling chocolate. Used a ball tool to give the horn pattern. I gave it a twisted look and liked it. Use the drawstring tool to shape it again. Painted a red gel color over the front neck pattern. You can also airbrush if needed, but I also wanted to give a pattern with colors, hence decided to paint. Please don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. Finish the pattern. Applied edible metallic blue for the rest of the dragon's body. Painted first layer of brown color for the horns. Give a second coat when it dried out. Finish the cake board with green fondant and use the drawstring tool to give a grass effect. Add stones wherever necessary or till you feel the design is complete. Apply dust over the stones to give a realistic stone effect. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. Thank you.